In this problem, we're told the kinetic energy of an object can be given by this formula, 1/2 mv squared. And the units of that come out to joules, provided the mass is written in kilograms. So we better make sure we do that. And the speed is written in meters per second. And then we're told we measure the mass of an object with uncertainty to be 380 plus or minus 20 grams. And I want to convert that to kilograms. So that's 0.380 plus or minus 0.020 kilograms. And then the speed is measured to be 2.2 plus or minus 0.1 meters per second. And then I want to get the kinetic energy, which is just a matter of plugging into the formula that we were given. But I also want to compute the uncertainty in the kinetic energy properly by using the propagation of errors formulas. So we'll start out by getting the kinetic energy. That's 1/2 mv squared. I plug in my mass of 0.380 kilograms, my speed of 2.2 meters per second. And I need to square that. And I get 0.9196 joules. Now I need to get the uncertainty in the kinetic energy, and we use a propagation of errors formula for this. And if you're wondering where this comes from, I'll post a link to the video where it was first introduced. And what I do is I look at what measured quantities does the kinetic energy depend on, and that's the mass, and that's the speed, but the speed is raised to the second power. So the mass term looks like this, and the way that exponent on V factors in is you have to put that factor of 2 out in front of the delta V over V before you square that term. And then we put our uncertainty for M in there, that was 0.02. And then M itself was 0.380. I'll just cut off that zero. We square that. And then we add to 2 times a 0.1 for delta V over V itself, which was 2.2. And then we square that. So we're going to add those 2 squared terms, take the square root. And that gives us the relative uncertainty in the kinetic energy. That's delta KE divided by KE. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 0.105. So to finish the problem, I still have to isolate the uncertainty in the kinetic energy. And to get that done, I have to multiply both sides by the kinetic energy itself. And that was 0.9196. And I end up with 0.097. And we usually follow a convention of rounding the uncertainty to one significant digit. And that means I have to round up into the tenths place and get a 0.1 out of this. So there's an uncertainty of 0.1 joules. Next, we're going to round the actual calculated quantity here, the kinetic energy. We're going to round it to the same decimal place as where the uncertainty appears, and that's the tenths place. And the reasoning there is if there's uncertainty in the tenths place, there's no reason to say what's going on in the hundredths place, thousandths place, and so on. And I can finally state my kinetic energy with the proper uncertainty on it, and that's 0.9 plus or minus 0.1 joules. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab. And best of luck on your math and physics journey.